Well, 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 another AMD GPU is gonna be launched, and no, it's not the RX 5800, it's the RX 5500, my friends. Yeah, let's just take a moment to appreciate the energy and the tech that goes behind manufacturing these GPUs. Props to AMD, man. Come on, let's give them a round of applause. You know, let's take a moment to reflect upon AMD. Just do that. Just take the moment and yeah, just. Now, I know that a lot of you guys were hoping for something that would compete against the RTX 2080 Ti or some other high-end GPUs from NVIDIA or even the more affordable GTX 1660 series, but that isn't the case with this new GPU. In fact, it does neither of those. And if we were to expect a higher-end GPU from AMD, with the current shortages affecting AMD's 7-nanometer process, it would significantly take, it would take us longer time for those to even come out in the first place. So there's that. But before you ignore the RX 5500 just because it's a boring entry-level graphics card from AMD, you need to know a few things, like why we think this might be AMD's or one of AMD's most important GPU launches of 2019, why it needs to succeed or how it could fail. So let's take a closer look at this right after a quick message from our sponsor.
The GamerStorm Castle 240EX gives you a peace of mind with anti-leak tech inside by reducing pressure buildup as temperatures fluctuate. Plus, this is one of the best looking pump designs with the removable mirror cover and swappable logo pieces with full addressable RGB support for that extra bling. Check it out below.
All right, so I'm gonna start this video with a little bit of flashback. Basically, while AMD's mid to high-end GPUs have received regular updates over the past few years, their entry-level models haven't. That means a lot of the Radeon cards in pre-built desktops and notebooks are based off an architecture that's 4 years old. Even on retail shelves, almost every AMD GPU that's under $200 is an RX 500 series that's built around a 4th-gen GCN technology. Now, 4 years might not sound like a lot, but in tech terms, that's a lifetime, guys, especially when we have NVIDIA launching much more powerful and efficient GPUs that's relatively affordable as well. So basically, AMD was in desperate need of an update, and that's where the RX 5500 series comes into play because it's based off the new 7-nanometer RDNA architecture. From a spec standpoint, there are gonna be a couple of cards being offered and pricing isn't available yet, even though they'll be available in October or November. On the desktop side, there'll be both 4 GB and 8 GB cards with 14 GB per second GDDR6, which operates on a 128-bit memory bus and offers 1408 cores across 22 compute units. That's a little more than half of what the RX 5700 XT has. Personally, I think the RX 5500M will be targeted towards slim and light notebooks, and its specs are pretty similar to the desktop variant. It operates at lower clocks and has 4 GB of memory. As usual, the RDNA architecture significantly improves performance while lowering power consumption and also decreasing die size. Honestly, for desktop users, these things are less of a concern, but this is a huge deal for the notebook market. AMD didn't really share all that much about performance, but what they did show was pretty interesting. If these numbers are accurate, then expect roughly the same frame rates as an RX 580 or something that sits between the GTX 1650 and a GTX 1660. So this actually brings me to one of the reasons why the RX 5500 might be so important for AMD. Right now, NVIDIA doesn't have anything that can directly compete against it in the desktop or notebook segments. Sure, that might change in the next few months, but the Radeon lineup desperately needed some fresh blood at affordable price points. The only red flag here is that these numbers are expected performance rather than actual numbers, so keep that in mind. Personally, I think the big highlight of this launch is the RX 5500M because right now, the GTX 1650 mobile GPU offers an amazing combination of performance and efficiency for thin and light notebooks. For example, the new Razer Blade Stealth will come with an Intel Ice Lake CPU and the option for GTX 1650 graphics. The RX 5500 could give notebook manufacturers access to even more graphics horsepower in their small form factor designs. So why is the RX 5500 so important for AMD? Well, first of all, it gives system builders an alternative to the GTX 1650 for their more affordable gaming rigs. Secondly, it can be used in notebooks where GPUs like the RX 570, RX 580, or even the 5700 series cannot be used because they simply produce way too much heat and of course consume a lot of power. Seriously, the Radeon lineup needed newer products so that they can sell it in bigger volumes to fund future development, and that's exactly what's happening here. It actually allows notebook manufacturers like MSI to come up with designs like this, the Alfa 15, which is a 15-inch thin and light gaming notebook. It has a 3750H CPU, the RX 5500, 144Hz FreeSync display, and more, which is exactly what we would want from an all-AMD gaming notebook. That's a big step away from something like the cheap-looking FX505 we saw at this year's CES. But what about the concerns that I mentioned at the beginning of this video? Well, those come down to power consumption and heat management, since while AMD's RX 5500M is an improvement over previous generation, it still looks inefficient compared to NVIDIA's notebook models. You see, AMD claims that the RX 5500M has a nominal power consumption of 85 watts, and that can be configured upwards or downwards based on what a notebook design requires. Meanwhile, NVIDIA claims their GTX 1660 Ti notebook GPU can be configured anywhere from 60 watts to 80 watts. Even though both AMD and NVIDIA measure power consumption differently, the performance difference between these two GPUs is going to be massive, but they have similar power specs. Also, just for your reference, the GTX 1650 Mobile is rated between 30 watts and 60 watts. Heat and power consumption are two huge factors for notebook manufacturers, so we'll just have to wait and see how they'll be able to incorporate the new RX 5500. Now, another issue that I might see AMD run into is delays caused by bottlenecks in the 7-nanometer manufacturing process. You see, we're already starting to see prices on Ryzen 3000 CPUs skyrocket, and that could potentially affect availability of these new GPUs. So that's definitely something that I'm a little worried about. So that pretty much covers everything. And you know what, guys? I'm actually pretty excited for this little graphics card because it gets the latest architecture from AMD into a smaller form factor and power envelope. And I think that's a great alternative for system builders who are looking to build affordable gaming rigs. And that's great news. But I want to know your thoughts about the RX 5500 in the comments down below. I'm really curious to know what you guys think. Are you excited about it? Because I know it's pretty boring, but curious to really know what your thoughts are. I'm Ibor with hardwarecanucks. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to check out some relevant content over here. Subscribe and hit the notification button so that you don't miss out on a new video. I'm signing off, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one.